Well, thank you for talking to me today about Paddington 2, which has been my favourite film of the entire year.
Oh, good.
I loved every single second of it. Came out crying and laughing and everything. What do you think is, the enduring quality of Paddington?
Gosh. Well, I think, bearing in mind that the first stories were written in the late 50s and are still in print and still, beloved now, I guess it's partly because as a character, we all have a bit of Paddington. We've all been in his situation. We've all been strangers in a strange place, be it a new school or a new town or a new country, and have all depended on the offer of friendship from others at some point in our lives. So I think that's one of the reasons. And then added to that, just the fun and adventure that he gets and the scrapes he gets into. And of course, the marmalade sandwiches.
Nothing else.
Just so charming. Now, Hugh Grant in this film is the most incredible thing I've ever seen. And he's a master of disguise. What would your go-to disguise be?
Policeman.
Mm. Oh, very good.
That's a classic one.
You can steal Hugh's if you want.
Well, I was going to say a suit of armour is pretty good.
Yeah,
you can tiptoe unnoticed through the streets of London in that, or clank around anyway, without too much trouble. But the fun that his character has with all those different disguises is just great. And what was great when we were filming on Paddington Station, for instance, when he, towards the end of the film, where he's dressed as a sort of train guard, passers-by literally didn't recognise him, so he wasn't stopped for autographs or anything because the makeup and the disguise was so convincing.
Oh wow,
cloak of invisibility.
I was thinking of that.
Then you're completely disguised.
That's the way to do it. I was thinking,
should magic exist at the moment, but then. Yeah,
it does.
That is the
best. Well, it does. I mean, I'm invisible most of the time.
Now, I read an article today that said that young people are killing marmalade. Apparently, young people aren't buying marmalade anymore. Oh. I just had my first marmalade sandwich out there. I'm a convert. I was wondering if you had a kind of public service announcement for why young people should be eating more marmalade.
Because it's marmalade. It's nice. It's actually nice to eat. It's... Why wouldn't you?
Well, it originated, didn't it? With Marie Malade. It was a source of comfort in the French court, I think, when someone was poorly. So it was a sort of sugar rush, I suppose. Yeah. So long as you don't put too much sugar. I know there's an awful lot of sugar in marmalade, but the sweetness and the spice makes it especially nice. See, there's a sort of tagline.
I was thinking of doing that classic. Are you struggling with marmalade? But then I just thought, no, that's not going to work.
No, he's topped you with
that. Yeah, I'm imagining the Got Milk posters that used to be everywhere.
Yeah, I don't get that. What does it mean, Got Milk?
Well, it was just trying to get people to drink more milk because it had calcium in it. Anyway.
Go to work on an egg. That was one you won't remember.
Wow, I didn't even know that one.